When you defend Luka Doncic, you have to pick your poison. You making him pass or you making him shoot? We're here in the studio with Bobby to run it back and to see what the Pacers did.
So teams like double-teaming Luka more than any other player in the NBA. So Luka's bringing it up here against the Raptors, and they send two his way already. Now, let's do some counting. There's one Raptor, two, and three defending four Mavs. If Luka's able to beat this double team, someone is going to be wide open. Okay, so Luka's able to split these two, get in the lane. Scotty Barnes sinks in to help, and that leaves Tim Hardaway Jr. wide open in the corner. This was almost a triple team. When you do that, you are daring Luka to pass. But what the Pacers did is something a little different. So Luka brings it up here. Now Miles Turner is going to come to the level of the screen and then retreat with Luka as he turns the corner to contain this drive. And even after a rescreen, he does the same thing. So as Luka gets to a point on the floor where he wants to pass, every single Mav is guarded by a Pacer. There's nobody open, so he has to settle for this contested fadeaway. Now, we know Luka's good enough to make that shot, but the Pacers are essentially daring him to make that shot 30 times.
So how do the Mavericks counter this?
There's a couple different ways. So the Mavs run Spain pick and roll. Very often, it's where Lively's gonna screen Luka's man, Josh Green is gonna come screen Lively's man, and the objective is to get Luka a downhill drive to the rim. But as this play unfolds, the timing is off. Luka wants to pass the ball, Lively's not to the rim yet, Doug McDermott is already in position. The only guy that's open is Jaden Hardy, but look at all this traffic. Luka can't see that pass, so again, he has to settle for this difficult fadeaway. Now, we just saw him make that shot, but you're never gonna shoot 100%. You want to find easier shots, but everybody needs to be on the same page in this action in order to generate a good, clean look. There's another way to do it too. So against the Raptors, Poeltl comes up to the level of the screen, but Luka's going to reject Derek Lively's screen and cross over, get into the middle of the defense and force the Raptors into rotation anyway. And then it's a simple matter, bing, bang, bong, Derek Lively dunk. So these things happen very quickly. They're very well coordinated actions. Everybody's got to be playing five guys on a string here if you're going to try and beat the Pacers the way that they defended Dallas the other day.
Will the Pacers change their game plan? Will the Mavericks counter that? We get the answers to those questions tomorrow night as the Pacers are back in town here in Dallas to play the Mavericks. He's Bobby. I'm Isaac here in Studio 41. Catch out more content on the Dallas Mavericks YouTube channel.